Alright, so in the last class we have seen the definition of linear density and planar density, which means the number of atoms sitting on a lattice direction, right, crystallographic direction, divided by the length of the vector, or the length of the crystallographic direction vector, is what is called linear density. And similarly, we have also defined planar density, right. So we will see in the next module, where we are going to talk about imperfections, what is the, I've requested you guys in the first class, you need to keep quiet, okay. If you cannot stop talking, you can write it on a piece of paper to your friend. You can communicate in the old ways, not using mobile phone, okay. Alright, so we have defined this linear density and planar density. And if you see, I have also discussed what is the most densely packed plane in FCC, and I said it is 111 plane, and I have asked you to go back and then check what will be the most densely packed plane in BCC and so on, right. I hope you have done that. So how do you go about calculating the planar density for, say, for instance, copper? Copper is an FCC crystal. And what is the planar density on 111 plane, given the radius of the atom to be 1.128 nanometers, alright. So that is our 111 plane. And if you look at the actual structure here, we are only representing, in this case we are only representing the position of the atom, but the given the size of the atom and the lattice parameter, and if you would actually look at the real scale, this is what you will see, okay. And then, of course, when you are doing this planar density calculations, you will realize that only 1/6 of this atom falls in that plane. And as a result, you will have these three areas contributing to only 1/6 of it, and remaining three are 1/2 of it, right. So that is 1/6, and the lattice parameter here is a by root 2 by knowing this a and this as a. A cubic crystal, so we know that this is A and this is A and this also as A. If you actually construct the crystal structure, so what I suggest you guys to do is go back and try to choose an atom size, and all of you guys know fusion 360, right. Try to construct this structure, and then you will realize that that is the closely packed plane, okay. This can be better understood by doing it. And if you are even more enthusiastic, I suggest you guys to use this open source visualization tool called Obito. It actually means open source visualization tool, Obito, okay. So this is a really a nice tool wherein you can actually construct crystal structures. You can download the input files for FCC, BCC and other kinds of crystal structure, and look at how they are written, and then you will be able to visualize them, and you can cut the planes of your choice. You can actually visualize 111 plane, how the atoms look like, and 110, 111, 100 and all the planes, and then you can rotate, so you will get a better feeling how this particular crystal structure looks like, okay. Both BCC, FCC, HCP, all the different kinds of crystal structure. It's really a nice tool. We will see in one of the tutorial classes, I will show you how to use this, okay. Alright, so you can calculate the planar density by playing with the number of atoms divided by the area of the plane, and then that will be your planar density, and you substitute the value for R given here, and then you will get the planar density for 111 plane in copper, okay. So this is what we call ballistic model. So this is something that you can actually construct very nicely in Obito, and then this is actually constructed in Obito. This is also constructed in Obito, and here this is an FCC crystal, but I have given three different colors, right. So I am showing you different planes basically, yeah. You can color that in that fashion so that you will get a good feeling for how the real crystal structure looks. looks like, and you can actually go inside and see how the gaps are there, what kind of spaces, free spaces are available, if you have an FCC structure and a BCC structure and so on. Okay? I seriously encourage you guys, go back and try this. It will really enhance your understanding of these structures. Okay? So, now you take this unit cell and stack it in 3D, translate in X direction, Y direction and Z direction, and you will construct an FCC lattice, of special lattice of this thing. Okay? That's how it looks like in full 3D. Alright, what are the different kinds of materials or elements that you have in FCC periodic table that have FCC crystal structure? I have only written couple of them. You can see gold, copper, aluminum, silver, lead, platinum, and so on, and gamma iron. This is gamma. Gamma iron. They all have face-centered cubic structure, right? It is good to remember what are the elements that have FCC, BCC, and so on. At least the popular metals that you are familiar with, right? In some sense, we have to remember as Indians, the most expensive ones are FCC, right? This guy, and if you want to take a gift or want to give a gift, this is what you prefer, right? So, they are usually FCC, right? So, in addition to what we have discussed in the class, I encourage you guys to go through these two YouTube links. They give a really nice explanation of the crystal structures, both FCC, BCC, and FCC, all three crystal structures that we are discussing in this class. Yeah. So, I am sure that if you have patience and go through this video, you will have much better understanding of these systems. Right? So, we have discussed linear density and planar density. So, 1D is over, 2D is over, and then right, and we have talked about planes, and then you need to talk about volumes. So, that is what is called atomic packing density, right? It's a volume fraction in some sense. How is the packing density of this crystal structure? So, for instance, if you take FCC, what you need to look at is the volume of atoms in the unit cell divided by the unit cell volume. What is the volume of this unit cell? The volume of this unit cell is A cube. A is equal to 2 root 2 r, right. So, you know the volume of the unit cell by knowing the radius of the atom that you are taking, and if it is FCC, you need to know volume of the atoms in the unit cell. How many atoms are there in a in one unit cell of FCC? If you carefully look at, so when you are looking at the unit cell, right, if you want to construct, if you want to find out how many atoms are there in one FCC unit cell, you also need to think about the surrounding environment. So, this guy, you have to imagine a full three-dimensional crystal lattice and then see how each atom is shared by other unit cells, right? For instance, if you take one corner atom is shared by 8. So, effectively you only have 1/8 of the atom belonging to one unit cell. How many such corner atoms are there? 8 corner atoms. So, all the corner atoms together will give you effectively one atom per FCC unit cell. Very good. And how about the face center? Each face center is shared by 2 unit cell. So, effectively you have 1/2 an atom per face center position. So, how many such face centered atoms are there in FCC? How many? 6. Very good. So, effectively you have 3 atoms. So, totally 4 atoms, and then you know the radius of the atom. So, the volume will be 4/3 pi r cube, right, divided by times 4/3 pi r cube times 4 divided by a cube, isn't it? So, that should give you the atomic packing density. So, what would that be for an FCC crystal? What would that be? I want you to give me a number. How much? Louder. 80%, above 80%. Okay. he's saying 80%. You guys don't want to say anything. Seventy-two percent. Okay, any other numbers? 74%. Why don't you just do a calculation and tell me? Why do you have to guess? It's a simple calculation, right? 37 you got. 73 you got. 74 somebody get. Simple multiplication and division seems to have different answers. So, are you doing the fraction properly? The numerator should be total volume of atoms in the unit cell, and the denominator should be volume of the unit cell. How many 74s? Yes, no change. 68s? 73s? No, change your mind. Okay, good. Okay. So, we need to think about certain properties of this crystal lattice. So, what is the coordination number? For FCC, the coordination number is 12. What do you mean by coordination number? How many nearest neighbors that a particular atom has in an FCC structure? Every atom in an FCC will have 12 nearest neighbors. That is why it is called, that is what is called coordination number. You need to verify that. Okay? So, we know that we have just now discussed each corner atom is shared by 8 unit cells, each face atom is shared by 2 unit cells, effectively you have 4 atoms per unit cell, and then atomic packing density, if you calculate, you should get 74%. And FCC is known to be a close packed structure, okay, amongst all the crystal structures that we have looked at, unit cell geometries that we have looked at, FCC is one of the closely packed structures. So, this is the maximum packing density that you can get for any crystalline material, right? If you take BCC, what would that be? So, that is A. So, this is your body centered cubic structure, right? How many atoms are there per unit cell? 2 atoms. Very good. So, what are the elements that have BCC structure? Chromium. What is W? And alpha iron, delta iron, molybdenum, vanadium, sodium, tantalum, and many more. Okay. So, what is the lattice parameter for BCC? It is 4R by root 3. Because the only the body diagonal atoms are touching each other. Right. So, and then the coordination number for BCC is 8. So, if you take a full 3D lattice, you can take any atom, you can see any atom as a body centered atom or a corner atom, depending upon how you choose, right? So, now you look at this body centered atom, it is surrounded by 8 atoms. So, that is how it is easy to say that there are 8 nearest neighbors, okay? One center atom, effectively 2 atoms per unit, and the atomic packing density is 68%, okay? So, FCC is more densely packed than BCC, which means there is more free space in a BCC unit cell compared to FCC unit cell. Keep that in mind. The packing densities of FCC and BCC, you should be able to calculate on your own if you cannot remember. Okay? So, then you have a hexagonal close pack structure. The elements cadmium, magnesium, zinc, alpha titanium, alpha tin, cobalt, beryllium, hafnium, and so on. Okay? They have hexagonal close pack structure. Again, HCP has a coordination number of 12 and atomic packing density of 74%, same as your FCC structure. You can calculate that and show that. So, you can see that if you take this atom surrounded by 6 here and the below next that is 6, so that is why you can see that it is a 12 coordination. Okay? Okay. So if you would look at the periodic table, this orange color elements are BCC, and this is pink, right? The pink color is HCP. I am bad at color, so if it is not pink, whatever it is, okay. And this is actually yellow, and this is orange, I think. Okay, all yellow are BCC, all orange are FCC, and whatever this color is, that is HCP, and so on. And I actually try to calculate how many elements are BCC, FCC, and HCP, and there are 21 elements which are BCC, 27 are FCC, and 27 are HCP. And in this, you see that there are certain elements whose crystal structure is written in brackets, right? So they are the predicted crystal structures. We probably don't know exactly their crystal structure, but they are theoretically they are predicted, and they found out to be BCC. That is why they have written, they have been written in brackets. Okay. For instance, these things we have no knowledge about their crystal structure. Okay. And then you need to calculate, how do you go about calculating theoretical density? This is something that you would have done in your plus 2, right? So the theoretical density of, for instance, if you have to calculate the theoretical density of copper, whose atomic radius is 0.128 nanometers and atomic weight is 63.5 gram per mole. So you can do that calculation using the formula. I am not deriving this formula in the class, but I think this is something that you have learned in your plus 2. If you did not, please go back and verify your textbooks. It is also available in Calister. So you can actually see the derivation, wherein n is the number of atoms associated with the unit cell, and the atomic weight A of the particular atom that we are looking at, and Vc is the volume of the unit cell. By knowing the crystal structure, you will know the, you will be able to calculate the volume of the unit cell. For instance, there is copper. Copper is which structure? Copper is FCC. So you can calculate, by knowing the radius of copper atom, you can calculate the volume of the unit cell, and Na is Avogadro's number, that you know, right? So like that, you can actually calculate the theoretical density of copper, right? So when we are talking about closed pack structures, we have said that both FCC and HCP are closed pack structures, but they are different in a subtle way. So how they are constructed, FCC and HCP structures. So for instance, if you have all A's are atoms, so you have constructed them in a closed packed way, right? And now you have two kinds of vacancies, not vacancies, free spaces here. There are B type free spaces and C type free spaces. The B type free space is like that, and C type free space is like that. That is B type, that is C type, right? Basically inward. Are you able to see that? Yeah. Now, this is the first layer of atoms, and now if I pack the next layer of atoms at B, now I have A and B. So first I have stacked the A layer, and then the next layer of atoms are stacked at a B position, right? And if the next layer is stacked at again A position, then what you will get is A, B, A, B, A, B. Instead of doing that, if you do A, then B, and then C, then you will get A, B, C, A, B, C. If you continue that, then you will have A, B, C, A, B, C. One of them will be HCP, another one will be FCC. Okay? That is A, B, C. Previously, we have seen A, B, A, B, A, B. Now, A, B, C, A, B, C. If you see that, this is your A, B, A, B structure. That leads to your hexagonal closed pack structure. If you have A, B, C, A, B, C, you will get face-centered cubic structure. Okay. Again, I suggest you please go back and try to do this on your own. Okay. So this is your ABC, ABC structure. All right. So before we move on to the next, yeah. So you can actually construct these closed pack structures and then see how one can generate FCC and HCP structures. If you were to generate these, if you want to soil your hands, all that you can do is you can have these steel balls and some neodymium magnets, right? And then use these two things to put together and then construct this AB, ABC lattices, and then you will be able to see the difference between HCC and HCP structure. Okay? And alright, so this I will discuss at a later stage when we need to discuss about the vacant sites. So, we have just now discussed that in FCC and BCC, you will have some free space, right? So, there are different kinds of free spaces. So one type of vacancy or vacant site is called tetrahedral site, and another type of vacancy is called octahedral site. So, tetrahedral space and octahedral space. So, each one of them will have different, this is your tetrahedral void space and this is your octahedral void space, and the volume of the tetrahedral void space is going to be different in different kinds of crystal structures and vice versa. And some crystal structures you may not have both the void spaces available, you may have only one kind of them available, and so on. Okay. I think right now I am not going to spend time on here, but when we are talking about defects, we will try to look at it. Okay. Alright. So, just now we have discussed about the stacking of atoms in order to generate the closed pack structures ABC, 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 and AB, AB, AB. Suppose if you make a mistake in the stacking, that means you are introducing a stacking fault in the crystal lattice. So, a stacking fault is nothing but an irregularity in the packing sequence of atoms in crystal. For instance, in FCC, the usual packing is ABC, ABC, ABC. And instead of doing this packing, if you do ABC and then forgot to put A and then BC, ABC. Here it is perfect, here it is perfect, and here you made a mistake. So that's sort of a defect in the crystal. Right? This is what is called stacking fault. So the fact that you have introduced a stacking fault, there is an energy associated with this stacking fault, and that energy is going to be called as stacking fault energy. And you have, depending upon the kind of stacking faults, you have materials which have high stacking fault energy and low stacking fault energy. You just, at this point of time, it suffices for us to know that there is something called stacking fault, which is due to a missing layer of atoms in the closed pack structure. Yes? And because of the introduction of that defect, that kind of a stack fault, your crystal's energy, internal energy is going to increase. And that is what is called, the energy associated with that particular fault is called stacking fault energy. Okay. So, depending upon the width of the stacking fault, you can call them as narrow stacking faults or wider stacking faults, and then there is an energy associated with them. We will discuss about this in the next module. What is the meaning, what is the implication of having a high stacking fault energy system and a low stacking fault energy system? How does that leads to the different kinds of deformation behavior in